It's not every day that you come across something very mind-blowing. In my opinion, the company that we're going to talk about today will be as important to humanity's future as the internet, the mobile phone, and money. In other words, every human will interact with the technology being built by this company in one way, shape, or form. The company in question is Fetch.AI. FetchAI is an artificial intelligence company from Cambridge that has a more than passionate team on its arsenal. A brief note on the team. CEO Humayun Sheikh was an early investor in DeepMind and has experience in the commodity sector. COO Toby Simpson was head of software design at DeepMind. There are over 45 other highly specialized employees like multi-agent system managers, machine learning specialists, data engineers, lead economists, etc., and advisors within this company. FetchAI is set out to change the world by capitalizing on the use of three fundamental concepts at its core: artificial intelligence, blockchain and distributed ledger technology, and multi-agent-based systems. FetchAI is building an open-access, tokenized, and decentralized machine learning network to enable smart infrastructure built around a decentralized digital economy. Data is the new oil. And the earlier you figure out how to make use of it in a sensible way, the bigger the advantage you have over everyone else. This has been noticed by the world's biggest nations like Russia, China, and the US. President Vladimir Putin is noted to have said that the nation that leads in AI will be the ruler of the world. Generally, I think most people agree that artificial intelligence will change the world. In fact, it already is. FetchAI is a blockchain/distributed ledger technology company that has materialized some pretty groundbreaking concepts in the field of agent-based multi-stakeholder systems that harness the power of artificial intelligence, as well as taking advantage of the economics, security, decentralization, and scalability brought about by the distributed and cryptographic technology infrastructure. In fact, one of the co-founders of FetchAI, Toby Simpson, quoted Douglas Adams on how big space is and how that's nothing in comparison to version 1 of the Fetch Agent framework that was released on March 31st of 2021. With the mainnet, all holders of the Fetch token, which is the native utility token that is key to unlocking the Fetch ecosystem, can now transfer their ERC20 Ethereum-based tokens to the Fetch AI mainnet, where they can be used to run validator nodes, delegate the Fetch tokens to validators, find, create, deploy, and train agents in order to facilitate smart contracts, oracles, and the transactions needed to deliver the new digital economy. Quoting the company in their own words, quote, FetchAI is an AI and digital economics company. We create dynamic marketplaces so that everyone can monetize the data they own and get access to the data they need. We have created a safe, secure, and trusted digital ecosystem with the power to transform the way we live and do business. This is all made possible by Fetch's open economic framework, a map for a new world which real and unreal estate exist in harmony. The framework enables the interaction of these marketplaces to interpret and provide efficiency within a trusted infrastructure. End quote. Fetch is a decentralized digital world that provides a value proposition where it's precisely adapted to each of its inhabitants or digital entities, and these entities are what we refer to as autonomous economic agents. These agents will redefine the way we understand data ownership and monetization. They can gather, transform, and package information and services and deliver precisely what you want right at your doorstep. These personal representative agents will give priority and optimization to many aspects of future technology as we know it. In transportation, for example, an agent through the agent framework can spot out all variables that it needs, such as weather alerts, speed cameras, traffic warning signs, petrol stations, etc., in order to make clever, well-informed decisions. Agents can represent all kinds of devices, such as washing machines, power stations, autonomous vehicles, and these devices can transact and negotiate with each other, all the while communicating back vital information to their owners or users, and this could be anyone that initiated the agent. Given the potential scale of the Fetch AI ecosystem, as a technology that might be embedded in the very nature of the Internet of Things, at its core lies a ledger that can scale to millions of transactions per second, achieved through parallel resource lanes that can multiply to meet demand. FetchAI has been designed to be a platform for collective superintelligence whose computational power is harnessed by machine learning algorithms to provide the network's intelligence. The FetchAI ecosystem revolves around a couple of key important product suites, which are the agent framework, collective learning, the simple open economic framework, and the ledger. The agent framework is a development suite currently implemented in Python, which equips you with an efficient and accessible set of tools for building and running agents. The framework is modular, extensible, and composable. It attempts to make agent development as straightforward an experience as possible, like web development and using popular web frameworks. The Fetch Collective Learning Module is a tool that enables distributed parties to work together to train machine learning models without sharing the underlying data or trusting any other individual participants. This architecture can help different data points and nodes to connect and collaborate with each other while deploying very low-cost solutions to training massive machine learning dataset models, whilst keeping all data in the ecosystem private and anonymous. The Simple Economic Framework, also known as the SOEF, is a dynamic environment and it's the latest version of the FetchAI's search and discovery system for agents. The agents can describe what they look like, what they do, and find or be found by other agents. They can search semantically while specifying the things that are important to them. The process is like a dance of sorts. The agents have personality pieces that enable this process. If you remember the taxonomic rank used in biological classification of living and fossil organisms, the agents in the FetchAI framework are also organized in a useful hierarchy of genus, architecture, classification, service keys, etc. All these characteristics act as building blocks towards each agent's own intelligence and ability to make independent decisions based on prior knowledge and present situation. They can also be customized by changing their underlying code within their skills, protocols, and connections. In the skills, an AI developer writes skills that the framework can call, which include modules for behavior, task, and handler classes. In protocols, when manipulated, they can be used to determine the governance role that the underlying protocol will bear upon the particular agent. And in connections, this essentially wraps an SDK or API, and an AI can interact with multiple connections simultaneously. And the ledger. This underlying layer is where all the magic happens. The blockchain and smart contracts capabilities in this layer permit the coordination and governance in a secure and auditable way. There are many other important aspects of the network that are made possible by the pivotal products mentioned above, such as the DDN or Decentralized Delivery Network and the ACN or Agent Communication Network, which utilizes unique addresses and private keys to detect and communicate with other agents. All these pieces and many others come together to make up the collective nature of the FetchAI ecosystem. Agents are agent-oriented as opposed to object-oriented. This is especially useful for asynchronization as the preferred method for designing agent processes and interactions. Asynchronization enables an agent to act upon a request without necessarily having knowledge of that which has made the request. In simple terms, agents work tirelessly together or alone to create tailored solutions to complex problems. This is a multi-stakeholder platform which is enabled by the agent's ability to operate as a heterogeneous multi-agent system, in the sense that they could be built within the framework or from a third-party network. This, in simple terms, is the ability for agents to interact with one another in a common environment to solve a common coherent task. Multi-stakeholder implies that the agents are not controlled centrally. They are permissionless, they are decentralized, and their identity comes from their unique addresses derived from a private / public key pair. Agents, like a swarm of drones, are independent but are made better by collectively working with information and behavior that is already learned by other agents. These agents exhibit goal-directed and reactive behaviors and, as a result, are able to make decisions based on their goals and beliefs. This is like ontology, the nature of being. Agents are philosophical and are somewhat brought to life by the way they make their decisions based on other characteristics such as intentions and capabilities. For an agent to be efficient, it needs to know when not to continue pursuing a specific task, else it risks getting stuck in the endless loop of incompetence. All this is meant to happen fast and without constant human intervention if an agent is to perform a repetitive task effectively. After all, an agent that constantly relies on a human for help is probably unhelpful, whilst an agent that never seeks assistance is potentially useless. This balance is very much needed in the execution of goal-directed behavior and reactive behavior. Agents also get smarter with time as they interact with both their owners and dynamic environment, which is in the case the simple open economic framework. Let's look at who Fetch.AI has strategically partnered with so far as per the information that has been provided to the general public. We have Bosch, Festo, T-Mobile Innovation Group, Blockchain for Europe, Datarella, Yoti, ZeroChain, GDA Capital, Fireblocks, Binance, Kudo, Waves, GraceOne, Trusted IoT Alliance, Sovereign, AIIN, Anchor, Conflux, and recently, Catena X Group. These aren't just random partnerships, but rather well-thought-out strategic choices that are meant to stress-test and expand the FetchAI infrastructure. They've also got a solid set of validators that help to secure the network, such as Cosmos Station, Staking Land, Fourball, Infostones, Validation Capital, Outlier Ventures, and others. Some example use cases of the FetchAI infrastructure that have been demonstrated by the Fetch team: delivery agents, autonomous AI travel agents, smart city field trials, commodity exchange and decentralized finance, collective learning, science agents, supply chains, transport and mobility, rail, smart parking and congestion solutions, smart e-mobility and electric vehicle infrastructure, thermometer agents, energy, smart homes, decentralized train networks, and that's just the tip of the iceberg. Applications that have been built for testing and optimization of the Fetch network in real life are agent registry and marketplace, decentralized delivery agents, stop-loss agents in DeFi, Fetch agent oracles. Oracles are bridges for the real world to the blockchain. Field trials are being run, and there is also an iOS SOEF viewer app that you can download right now that lets you look at the current agents in the Fetch world. Whether or not you are a programmer, you can download their latest AEA Manager app supported on Windows, macOS, and Ubuntu to test out an AEA in real life from the AEA library and reprogram the agent for your specific needs for the more technical savvy users. There's also their documents page, which will point you to all the technicalities you need to get started with building your own agents using the Fetch architecture. There's a ton of more information about FetchAI that I've left out, because otherwise this would go on for so long. So I urge you to check out their website and social media presence to learn more. What's my verdict? This could probably be explosively huge. That's where I'm going to leave it. In conclusion, if FetchAI eventually accomplishes what it is set out to achieve, I believe it will establish itself in a similar manner as Ethereum did as the most valuable and respected altcoin, but go a step further by surpassing that standard and completely altering the very nature of how humanity interacts with the Internet of Things, and ultimately becoming a bridge between the physical and the virtual world. Thank you for watching.